Military leaders contradict Biden, say they recommended 2,500 troops should stay. Joint Chiefs of Staff Chairman General Mark Milley and two other senior military officials faced tough questions during a Senate Armed Services Committee hearing on Tuesday about the American withdrawal from Afghanistan, defending their decision-making on a number of counts. Milley described the outcome in Afghanistan as a logistical success but a strategic failure during his testimony along with Secretary of Defense Lloyd Austin and General Kenneth McKenzie Jr., head of U.S. Central Command. McKenzie and Milley told the committee they had advised keeping 2,500 American troops on the ground in Afghanistan, contradicting comments made by President Biden last month in which he denied receiving such a recommendation. Austin said the swiftness of the collapse in Afghanistan took top brass by surprise, and they did not fully comprehend the extent of corruption and weak leadership in the government, and the military's lack of willingness to fight. Milley also acknowledged speaking to the authors of three books that included details of his contact with President Trump, but couldn't speak to the accuracy of how he was portrayed because he hasn't read them. "The president doesn't have to agree with that advice, he doesn't have to make those decisions just because we're generals, and it would be an incredible act of political defiance for a commissioned officer to just resign because my advice is not taken," Milley said when asked by Senator Tom Cotton, RR, why he hadn't resigned over the way the situation in Afghanistan was handled. "This country doesn't want generals figuring out what orders we're going to accept and do or not. That's not our job. The principle of civilian control of the military is absolute, it's critical to this republic." The U.S. withdrawal from Afghanistan in August has widely been viewed as chaotic. Afghans desperate to flee fell to their deaths after clinging to planes. 13 service members were killed during bombings on the Kabul airport attributed to the Islamic State. And an American drone strike initially described as righteous was eventually determined to be a tragic mistake that killed 10 innocent civilians, including an aid worker and several children, instead of Islamic State targets. America's longest war cost the lives of almost 2,500 troops, over 47,000 Afghan civilians, 66,000 members of the Afghan military and police, hundreds of aid workers and more. The U.S. is estimated to have spent at least $2.3 trillion on the conflict. A number of American citizens, Afghan allies and others remain in the country, something Senator Josh Hawley, RMO, called a disgrace during the hearing. Milley also defended calls he had with Chinese military leadership during the final days of the Trump administration, telling the hearing that they were coordinated with key officials including former Defense Secretary Mark D. Esper and Secretary of State Mike Pompeo. The general came under scrutiny for those conversations in recent weeks, though he reiterated on Tuesday that at no time was I attempting to change or influence the process, usurp authority or insert myself in the chain of command.